Good morning, Daniel.
Good morning. How are you doing?
I'm fine. And you?
Excellent. Yeah.
Let us start with IPT Barcelona High Roller, 10,000 euros event. There was something going on in ruling. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, well, so I'll start with how I woke up that morning. I worked out, and as I have been, and I was already antsy, and I'd lost about half my stack already, and I was feeling like I needed a break. So the timing was perfect. And then I stood up. I was standing next to my chair. I anteed my small blind. I physically threw my small blind in, standing at the table. My friend Philip Grusin was over at the other table, and I was like, hey, how's it going? What's going on? So I'm standing right here. My chair is right here. And the dealer just starts dealing and takes my hand and kills it. It's like, what the hell are you doing? I'm standing at the chair. It's like, no, you weren't standing at the chair. It was basically what she's saying is absolutely impossible, because there's a table here, chairs here. I can reach from that table. If I was standing on the table, I could still reach my arm. And the way the rule is written, it says you have to be within arm's reach of the chair. And I definitely was. That was clear. So she killed my hand, and I was annoyed, because first of all, I hate this stupid rule. So it just brought to a head all the annoyance I find about the rule and how horrifyingly ridiculous it was put into place without really, you know, consulting with the players first. And it's not a player friendly rule. It's a prison guard rule. If you're a prison guard, this is good for you. Stay in the seat. Sit the hell down. Shut up and play poker. Put your phone away. Keep your chips like this. Sit up straight. Sit down. Blah, blah, blah. It's good for that, you know, if you want to create that kind of environment. They've done a good job not having people socialize and all that kind of stuff. But so then I just got really annoyed. And I was like, screw it. I don't even want to be here right now anyways. I went all in blind. That way, I'm either going to double up and have a chance in the tournament, or I get to take a break because it was a re-entry tournament. So I went, I busted the hand, I went for a few hours, took a little break, and then I came back clear-headed, fresh, relaxed, and then I ended up coming second.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
And you really reached the final table and you got your money back and even more. And in the final table, you were playing with Joni Jokimainen, the young kid from Finland. What do you say about Joni?
Joni, you can definitely tell he has like a passion for the game, and he was definitely taking it seriously. So it reminded me when I was younger, you know, how amazing the experience was for him, you know, in that it was new. You could tell that, you know, wasn't at a lot of final tables, and he was happy to be there. Very aggressive in some spots that I probably wouldn't have been. You know, younger players play a little differently than I do. But, you know, he was tough to play against before the flop, that's for sure.
So, let's move on to EPT. 5 years ago, you said that EPT is going to be huge. And now we stand in a situation where the tournaments are much, much bigger than they were then. What do you say is going to happen in near future for EPT?
Well, no, the EPT is clearly the number one tour in the world. You know, one of the great things about it is after a few years of growing pains, they sort of find out which events draw the most people, which ones they like the best, and which ones maybe they didn't like so much. So now they've created a very strong tour of well-attended events, and they become vacation spots. And the best part of what they've done for people to make it worth traveling is create all the side event schedule, because now what you have is not just the main event, but if you bust that, you can play a high roller, you can play some smaller ones. So it justifies, you know, making the trip over.
And for example, here you are going to play a couple of more tournaments.
Well, you know, what I usually do is I don't play a lot of side events. What I'll do is I'll always play the super high roller, the main event, and then if there's one more high roller, that's about the end of what I'll play is three events.
Okay, let's move to ice hockey. Do you still play fantasy hockey?
I've been in the same league since 1996, and of course, yeah, it's a website called Alternative Hockey League. We have very cool rules where we have farm system. You know, we draft 14-year-old kids. So we study the league very well, and you know, it's fun. It's a lot of fun. It's not about the money, it's just fun.
Okay, you are still supporting, naturally, Maple Leafs in the league.
I'm friendly with Phil Kessel, who's one of the best players in the NHL, I can say fairly. And so him and Tyler Bozak and some of the guys, they're on the team, and I like them, so I root for them.
And naturally, we have to talk about Teemu Selänne. What do you say about Teemu?
I was always a big fan. When he scored 76 goals and, you know, for Winnipeg, his rookie season, that was just amazing. You know, and I love watching him play. He's got a great sense. And for him to do what he does at his age, I like that. You know, I'm 39. I'm playing with these kids who's supposed to, you know, supposed to be over the hill. And he's proving at 41 that he can still play. 43, pardon me. The years fly by. And that's just amazing. You know, I'd love to see him play another year. I know that it's unlikely, but you never know with him. He's yeah, definitely in shape, true. And he can do it.
Did you know that they made a movie about Teemu in Finland?
No, I didn't know that. Wow.
Yeah, you have to watch it. Really. Yeah. So, finally, how about your personal life? Are you happy?
I'm very happy. I'm in a really, really good place. I'm enjoying my life. I'm doing, for the most part, every day what I want to do. And I live every day, except for stuff like this. But for the most part, you know, I live a life that I always dreamed of having. And I see a future that's going to look a little different than it is right now. The one thing I don't like doing is traveling to Europe for very long stretches. And 6 weeks is a trip I'm on right now. It's a little too long. And this will be the last time I ever do that.
Okay. And how about your eating habits? Still eating vegetables and fruits?
Oh, well, I'm a vegan. Yeah.
Yeah.
I haven't
really?
Started eating cows or anything since the last time.
You're loyal.
Yeah. Yeah. Right.
Great to hear. I know that you are busy and you have to go to commentate the main event. So thank you for the interview and see you maybe next somewhere.
Sounds good. Yeah, I'll be around.
Thanks for the interview.
You got it, buddy.